Hello and welcome, Pocket Watch here, and it's about time for another episode of Riddle Busters. Let us go with the episode, because I think we'll meet with Kud again. Yup, at the vending machine. It should be fun. Let's go. I went to the courtyard vending machine, and there I found Kud. Is she done helping them? Helping who? She was standing in front of the vending machine, fiddling with her mantle, seemingly deep in thought about something. From time to time, she extended her hand to the bottom panel, but withdrew it, and resumed fiddling with her mantle shortly after again, so she can decide what to pick or something. I've been searching for members all this time, and here I have someone I know. Alright, it's decided. Oh my god. Kud might be better than Kamikita in baseball, maybe. Probably not. Why our team is so freaking useless? We have like 3 or 4 people that are able to play. Good. I called out to her. On closer inspection, she appeared to be holding something, like a bundle of cards in her hands. She went somewhere. Playing with cats, I think. Oh my god. Ito Izu. What? Let me just hear it. I don't think I can make this up. Like, you can let me know in the comment. What do you think that she said? It's... What? Is it great? Grato? Great? To me. Too. Great to me too, I think, but what is that? It is great to... What? I don't know. What do you think? What she just told us? Because I think it needs like some deeper knowledge about her language. Me too. I don't know what, but yeah.
Thank you.
Say, Kud.
Hi.
Those script notes, you made them yourselves? She shook her head. Okay. One person Doppler effect again. Well, that's okay, isn't it? I tried to cheer her up, since she was looking down. It's so strange to be using an electronic dictionary during overseas trips. But talking while looking at flashcards didn't seem very practical. She put away her flashcards and asked, "Ah, well, I looked her over from the from head to toe. Yeah, she's not really like built for baseball. She didn't appear to have any muscle. Don't turn into Masato. Her school uniform was loose, the sleeves concealing up to the backs of her hands, her hand, yeah." Her legs, wrapped in the white knee-high socks, were skinny. I don't think we ever saw bottom part of her model. So I like this! This information is cool. Sorry. I regained my senses, realizing that Kud was blushing deeply under my scrutiny. Say Kud, do you play any sports? Oh, okay. What do you play? Really? What kind? She began counting on her fingers. That's surprisingly a lot. And tennis, badminton? Maybe she can play a baseball, actually. I'm surprised.
Skateboard, curling, India ka, petanku.
I don't know what are these. Hang on, hang on. Well, somehow there were a lot of other things mixed in with this I was familiar with. So you like being active? Okay, makes sense. So she plays, but she's not really good at this. I felt it wasn't quite right, but I could understand what she was getting at for the most part. Then how about baseball? Yeah, baseball. In other words, baseball. Oh my god, I love this face. This is the first time we've seen this, I think. Yes. Okay, good. You are going up in ranks. She clapped her hands. Have you played them before? Okay. Well, I'm just wondering why you said that with such enthusiasm. Okay. She was trying to say that that's why she didn't know it. As that's how it is. No, nothing like that, but... Well, I'm playing baseball right now. So, I was looking for members. I was wondering if you would like to go to play. She clapped her hands together again. That's a good spirit. I like it. That would be great. I sent a text message right away saying that I found a new member. Oh my god, give me the another test. What test could we have to fill up and pass to get into team? Kyosuke, give it to us. And so, we lined up at the baseball field. Yeah, don't worry about this, we're good. Eh, what was it? Never mind them. Well, now I get it. They're trying to say Masato, but various things happens and I kind of went with the flow. Let's have her take a test, like always. Alright, Kyosuke. Okay, give me your test. I will just drink a bit of coffee. And I'm ready. Good, you absolutely don't know anything about baseball? She shook her head. I see, I'll start with explaining the equipment. Do you understand how the glove works? Wait, so we didn't get like... the test for her? That sucks. I'm disappointed.
Hey.
Alright, put it on then. She sat down on the ground. Good? What? What did she do? I put my hand on my forehead, standing in front of Good, who with great effort had managed to fit her foot into glove. I'm in pain together with you, Riki. I understand you. Oh my god. There's so much wrong, I don't even know where to begin with. You see that white thing over there? That's first base. Try running over there first, just as you are now. She fell after all. She got up. And she's back. Welcome back. How did it go? Tears welled up in her eyes. By the way, you wear the glove on your hand. While I made it, you put it on the hand opposite of the one you throw with. Is this new face as well? I love it. You cannot. You can't, and actually, why in the world did you go through the trouble to put gloves for lefties and righties on their respective feet? What the fuck? That isn't where the problem is. I'm afraid to imagine what's waiting for me ahead. Oh boy. Pretty much. Kyosuke, could you hit a few practice balls?
Yoshi, jaa Nomi, achi itte koi.
I like how high-spirited she is, even though she is doing like everything wrong. I like her. She spirited off in the direction Kyosuke had pointed out. Wouldn't it be better if she went a little further, Kyosuke? Good, move back a little and to the left. I really like her! Like, this personality is freaking damn amazing. Holy crap! She started moving again. Wait, why is she coming back to where I am? She spoke to me with rushed breath. What is that hood? Oh my god, yeah, maybe? Really? She turned back to her positions once I answered her. I feel like after I finish this game and I will have some, I don't know, just after I finish the game, I feel like I should go and try the road where I go end up with Kud. Like, wow. I wonder if that's even an option. Well, that's... The impressive sound of bold, talking fighter about. Whoa. That's all Masato and I could say. Kyosuke was sending the white balls flying away in an arc. Sometimes he would hit line drives. I think she's missing everything. Wow, she have like different face for every catch. She was moving her tiny body around with ease, stretching, crouching and jumping. She jumped up and caught the ball while landing. Oh! So she's actually doing pretty good! I did not expect that. Yeah, like, I'm in shock. Like, what the fuck? I would never expect that she would be good at least catching balls. Or actually, this feels strangely right for some reason. She returned carrying a heavy looking bucket of balls. Yeah, that's it. What's wrong, Masato? What? What are you babbling about? What the fuck? I see it now. She handed the balls to Kyosuke with a smile. Yeah. A dog indeed. Yup. Kyosuke was satisfied. It seems we've passed. She bowed her head politely in front of everyone. Rin. I called to Rin, who was standing a bit afar, and she quietly murmured a reply as well. We'll join the practice. Hell yeah. Oh no, Kud in battle system. Oh no. Don't bully Kud. P, yeah. We want to change in neighboring classroom. The convention here is that the boys get changed in the classroom next to ours, while the girls change in ours. For no apparent reason, Masato was strutting around with only boxers on, showing off in front of everyone. Just get changed already. Okay. He finally returned. Kengo's just so macho. No matter what class, he's always in this outfit. I started changing too. I haven't got my gym shorts. I've already dropped them on the floor when I took them out of my bag. Girls were still changing to our classroom. I will go there once they finish. No, I'm not hung up about my body. It's just that... You can go ahead. Don't make such a sad face. Come on, Kengo. Get him out of here. Follow me if you want. They finally left. I've got to hurry and find my gym uniform or it will be late. Let me guess, there will be one girl that is like forgot to change or is so slow that she's still in there or something. It's going to be like that, right? There shouldn't be any girls in the left in classroom. Yeah, foreshadowing, yep. I'm not going to be surprised. So let's just think about who can be inside. From this what we know, I think that might be Nishizono actually. Because she's kinda anemic. Maybe she takes longer to change. Because we know that she's actually changing, so... Yeah. Probably her. I don't think anyone else would have these problems. Maybe Kamikita? Nah, I think it's Nishizono. Thinking so, I opened the door. And... I was wrong. I shut the door before they could scream. Alright, so everyone! Holy shit! Three girls were standing motionless in the corner. Sorry. I stood waiting in front of the classroom. They all left almost immediately. Among them was one, Ito-san, if I'm not mistaken, who looked at me as if wanting to say something. Huh. In the end, she said nothing and walked away. What was that about? It seems like they had already finished changing. They probably stayed in the classroom to chat. After school, Kud, our new team member, rushed from the classroom as if chasing after Rin. We followed after them. I forgot once again checking how to do the mirror image on my camera. Because if I do a mirror image here, then I can still have the same, like, range of motion. And I would be able to get my microphone closer without obscuring your view, guys. Yeah, I will do that for the next episode. I will check if it's possible. So, we are walking along the passageway, when suddenly I looked in the direction of the courtyard. I couldn't see Nishizono-san under the Zelkova tree. A pebble by the road nobody cares about. Oh, that's sad. But if even once somebody did care about it, It would be says being case being trifling and become the only one of its kind. Well, she's going to PE, so yeah, that's why she's not on the tree. We know she's participating, kinda. I mean, she's sitting like under some trees or something, but yeah. I wonder what happened. Head off to practice, look for her. Okay, I'm kinda going into boots of Riki right now, not like myself. Because I probably would just head off to practice. Because I mean, it's going to be a lesson and she's probably on the lesson as well, so yeah, that makes like most sense. But I feel like I'm starting to care more about Nishizono and Riki also, so who knows, maybe something happened to her and we'll never know, so I'll go look for her. And actually, if we go look for her and she's actually on the practice, then we go to the practice as well, so I guess it's a win-win situation. Yep, let's go. Sorry, I need to go somewhere. Masato had a puzzled expression on his face as I walked away from him. I returned to the classroom. There weren't many people left in the classroom, but I spotted one familiar face among them. Kurugaya-san, have you seen Nishizono-san? I didn't expect to find her so easily, but I asked nonetheless, without any expectations. I see, thanks. I will look elsewhere. Wait, what? Okay. I was about to leave when she called to me. Yeah. Not really. You can hug me.
それはそれで楽しそうだが、この両膝は君にはまだ早いな。
No. Why are you suddenly asking this?
本当に耳掃除した方がいいか。まあ、もう一度言ってやろう。西園女子ならさっき見かけた。随分と気が流行っていると見える。何かあったのか。そもそも、リキ君は西園女子と仲が良かったか。
Well, sometime. No, that's not really it.
じゃあどういうわけか。ここはお姉さんに教えてくれないか。
That's something I'm worried about. I don't really understand it myself. It's just as today, I suddenly hadn't seen that scene. What? I suddenly hadn't seen that scene. Yeah, okay. Which I had gotten used to during the past few days. So, hey, what? Oh yeah, they're different classes, right? So, she's not... It's possible that Nishizono doesn't have practice or now in the PE. Right? They're in different classes? Yeah, I think so. You can help me and let me know in the comment. I thought like they all get the PE now, but yeah, I feel like they're in different classes now. So that makes sense. So this is actually true. That was weird that she's not under this tree. Maybe she's ill. Maybe she's not in the... Maybe Kurugaya saw her like not long time ago and she was feeling ill and went home or something. Or she's in like a nurse office. Yeah, that's the only reason. There are days where you want to go straight home and days where you feel like talking a small detour. Thank you.
さっきまで何か探し物をしているようだったさ。
Okay. Looking.
うん。机やカバンの中を
Oh, did she lost her like book? The important one that she always read? So what happened after that? What was she looking for?
Like
a book?
そうでないかもしれない。少年には何か心当たりがあるようだ。
I just realized she's strapping her hand between her hand and her hair.
まあ、私にはその程度しか言えない。
She stood up.
で、私はそろそろ練習に行くが、リキ君も一緒に行くか。
Wait, Kuruga is in different class than Riki, right? So they also have practice? Okay, I'm a little bit confused how this system works. Oh, maybe they all have practice, but Nishizono was worried about the book and she basically ignored the lesson. Yeah, that might be the case. Sorry, I will be there later. Or I might be not able to make it all today. Please let Kyosuke and everyone else know. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. She spoke from behind my back as I left the classroom. God damn it, I love her. Like, holy shit. I need to get to see her ending, if we can have it. I don't think it will happen in this playthrough, but maybe in the next one? Who knows? I had to do this to put my doubts to rest. I was probably overthinking things. It wouldn't be a big deal if that happened to be the case, but where on earth was she? I would be able to relax if only I knew. Even if I tried to think of places she might be. There was only one that came to mind, as Lakova tree in the courtyard. I went up to the fourth floor. I went down to the first floor. I checked the passageway. And the school gate. The cafeteria and the sport grounds. I stole a sidelong glance at everyone practicing there and headed once more for the courtyard. Nishizono-san wasn't there, but Rin was. Rin, have you seen Nishizono-san?
Yeah.
Okay, where she is. Really, where did she go?
Shiranai.
Good job! You're useless as ever! God damn it! Did someone hit the ball all the way over here again? She had the ball in her hand. Seems like she found it already. Oh. So she came here after all. Looks like she didn't ask Nishizono-san about ball's whereabouts. Well, nothing I could do about that now. Thanks. Okay, it's okay. That's quite normal for you, so yeah, don't worry. No, I have more important tasks. I need to save my waifu. Sorry, I will be there later. Too bad, I was just a little late. If only I knew her phone number, I could have avoided this mess. Constantly barely missing each other. It's like an old drama. I checked every place where I thought she might be, but she was nowhere to be found. Blindly wondering about the expensive school campus wouldn't be productive, I figured. The only place left was the dorm. Standing in front of the entrance to the dorm, wasn't Nishizawa-san. She was just about to go in. Nishizawa-san! She slowly turned around at the sound of my voice. Oh, she had her umbrella. This is like, even near at the night, she still have it. Just how delicate is the skin, like what? I wonder, like, what kind of light can person like this tolerate? I don't know to really know. I know there is like the disease or something that you are like overreacting for the light, I think. But I never checked like how severe it can be. Like, because in her case it seems like it's pretty severe. I mean, she's like wearing this umbrella like all the freaking time to cover herself up. Perhaps all that I wished was for was that she would smile, even if only a little. What about you, Nishizawa-san? What happened? Well, she wasn't under the Zelkova tree today. Did I have the right to ask her why? Always asking her why and what, that was probably as close as I was with her. Well, I hesitated. She said as though she was... as though there was nothing on her mind. But I still noticed. Deep inside her eyes was a color I hadn't seen before. A dim light of intense sadness. It was telling me that something bad had happened to her. The expression in her upturned eyes. It was all too familiar to me. Besides, I too had this look before. Probably before he met with the rest of little bastards like we had in the backstory. I don't remember the backstory well, to be honest. That is why I asked. You weren't in the courtyard today. Did something happen? And she answered. She said as forcing out the answer. She reached out to take the hand I would extend it to her. Like I once did, when Kyosuke and everyone else held out their hands to me. Compared to their 8 hands, my own too might not be that reassuring, but... Then, I will help you look for it. Mission start. That's what someone had said to me. I hope it will be mission success. Once again, we entered the classroom, this time together. Neither Kurugaya-san nor anybody else was in the classroom anymore. Avoiding the dazzling rays of the setting sun that permeated the room from the window, she walked up to her desk. Just to be sure, she slid her hand inside the cheeks, inside to check one more time. You had it during the afternoon as well, right? Yeah, it's probably in my classroom then. Because you were changing in the... basically my classroom. It can be helped. She probably did it more or less unconsciously. So, you did have it before PE class. There was only a short time between the beginning of the fifth period and when she noticed she had lost her book. She had been in the classroom since the end of PE, so she could only have lost it during that one period. At some point in that time frame, the book had been lost. Do you know if anybody else lost anything? This was the room where the girls had been changing. Considering this, It wouldn't be so strange if there were some people with bad intentions. Well, that's how it is. Otherwise, we would have heard about this. I let out a sigh unintentionally. What a bummer. But it didn't just go missing on its own. Something must have happened to it. For example, maybe someone was playing a distasteful prank. They hid the book somewhere or perhaps stole it. I don't think she ever considered this possibility. Naturally, the guess at the end of lunch break came to mind. I wonder, there was that one girl that wanted to tell us something? Maybe she is like, what was her name, Ito or something? Maybe she's aware of the situation of Riki and Nishizono, how they're getting closer. And maybe she wants to give him information that, hey, these girls did that and hid the book. So yeah. I wonder if that's what she wanted to tell us. But it was wrong to blame my classmates without cause. But it's important. You clearly are upset, so don't give me that. It will be not the same, it's probably something that you got like at some important time. She seems to be fighting back tears while putting up a strong front. Oh wait! I just re- Oh! The arrow keys! I can go back! Holy shit! I didn't knew that. She seems to be fighting back tears while putting up the strong front. I don't think that's the only the case. Oh, or she mean like literally, maybe there is someone wrote something in the book actually. Maybe she meant just the book. Oh my god, I'm so interested. You are not fine and we can hear that. But you would be happy if you found it. Then let's search for a bit longer. I have yet to help you. What is that even? Maybe I am. I have no idea what that is. Buzzy body. No idea. If you want to call someone a busybody, that would be Kyosuke and everyone else. What does it mean? I'm simply following in their footsteps. Then we just have to find it. Assholes all everywhere. Also, sadly, characters like Nishizono are really vulnerable for bullies. Like, this is really... it really sucks. Yeah. Of course I am. There are those with bad intentions in this world. But I believe that there's just as many people with good intentions in this world. Let's think it over one more time. She stopped resisting. Nishizono-san, are you sure you still had it when you went to the classroom after lunch? She She nodded. However, you don't remember if you put it in a bag or not. She nodded again. What if you put it in your desk and started changing? Nishizawa-san, where did you put your uniform when you changed? Oh my god, this face. No, it's not the case. Oh my god. The fuck are these assumptions? I can't even tell if she's serious or is she joking. Like, wow. My brain is melting. I have no idea what to do in this situation. Think a little better of me. So what did she think of me before? That's discouraging. No, that's not it. If she left the book with her uniform when she changed, she should have seen it after PE class when she changed back. But she didn't. I explained this to her. Great. So she was that serious. Okay, but then be careful. It was difficult to tell when she was being serious and when she wasn't. Yep, exactly. But there was no doubt that she really was bothered by this. Let me ask you this then. Did you make it to PE class on time? She was talking to me during lunch break before she went back to class, so given her pace, she would inevitably be late. Did you hurry to the sports field? That's why she didn't put the book in her bag. So from this point forward, we had to deduce what happened next. Nishizawa-san began changing, leaving her book on top of her desk. Riki is opening up the butler's brain. No, he's not, but yeah. Other case to solve. And she placed her uniform on the desk. She's organized, so she certainly folded it first. At the same time, she was doing it as quickly as possible to avoid being late for class. Even if she by chance dropped the book while doing so, she probably wouldn't have noticed. Maybe someone already picked it up. When I went into classroom to grab my gym uniform, there were still some girls in there. They had probably begun changing even later than Nishizawa-san. That's when they noticed the book lying on the floor. And let's think about it one more time. Yeah, it's probably that Ito girl. I think Ito was her name. I wanted to believe that they had... is this really important? Okay, that's surprising. Okay guys, this is a very interesting choice. Does it have impact on the story? You can let me know if this choice have impact on the future story. Yeah, you can let me know. I don't think just telling me if it having impact is any spoiler at all. It just tells me that this choice actually matters. I mean, I don't know. I guess we'll go with the good intentions. Because Ito wanted to tell us something. Or maybe that was... she wanted to tell us because the other girls did something bad. The they had. I don't know. I genuinely have no idea what to pick. Do I think these girls had good intentions or bad intentions? Nishizana is not bothering anyone, she just exists, I guess, in their classroom. So, I think they had good intentions, maybe. But on the other hand, why would Ito wanted to tell us something? I feel like she was like the only good one there, and the other two were bad. I feel like that might be the case as well. I know it takes a little bit longer to decide, but I'm really not sure what to do. Not this book lying on the land, and I mean, I don't know. I think I will go with bad intentions though. I feel like, I mean, this is very, very confusing, because I feel like Ito is the only one that was good there. I think that would be the case. Let's go with bad intentions. I feel like they had bad intentions. On the one hand, Nishizono is like a person that wouldn't bother anyone. I don't think like anyone should pick up on her. On the other hand, they're like weird people that just do it for fun, and this is like freaking terrible. And I think like Ito was the good one and the rest were the bad ones, so the majority were the bad ones. That's what I think, at least. Let's go with the bad intentions. Perhaps it couldn't even be called ill will. It wasn't clear who the owner of the book lying on the floor was. It was old and the cover was tattered from much use. Also, they could just, if it was on the ground, they could just pick it up and leave on the table, right? If they had like good intentions. Because the person who lost it would find it on the desk. Or just throw it into desk, and if it's not even the desk of someone who lost it, then they would find this book and hey, who's that? Whose book is that? Basically, so yeah. I think I'm on point with this. There were as many people who would think that book must be important, as people who would think it must be garbage. I went to the corner in the back of the classroom. I didn't look for it here before. I don't think Nishizono-san did either. I reached into the garbage can. I didn't want to look at Nishizono-san, but it was empty. Whew! Okay. Oh, wait. Fuck. Oh my god, sorry. Sorry for your ears. If you have headphones. They would finish cleaning the classroom already, so it was only natural. Shit. She asked in a worried tone. It wasn't there. Maybe it's in the West incinerator. I think the choice matters there. I think I chose the sad part. Did the students notice there was a book inside the trash can when they threw it away or not? I had no idea. Maybe they really threw away the book along with the rest of the trash. It was only a guess though. To the incinerator. She said in an assertive tone. I can still make it in time. They're supposed to be burning trash for a little longer. A precious book might be burnt as well. Come on! Because a light of Danielle flickering in her eyes. Wow, she can make like really serious face. Wow, Nishizono. Wow. She was looking at me intently. Her expression softened. That wasn't my intention. I tried to say it but couldn't finish. I'm sorry. In the end, we gave up our search for the book. I began heading back to the sports field. Yeah, later. She called out to me. I know. No shadow. I didn't know, but I couldn't say it in her face. Talking my silence for an answer, she continued. That's exactly why I should worry about you. That's the issue. Well, she gave us example of the pebble, but that's exactly what I was talking about before. Like, she's doing nothing to anyone, and like no one have reason to pick up on her, but some people just do it for fun. Like, you see a pebble, like, on the ground, you're like bored and you just kick it just to see how it flies. Just like that. Because, yeah, why not? It's just a pebble, like, no one cares. Yeah, that's the reason. Like, I'm worried. I'm genuinely worried. Like, holy shit. Maybe it's not as extreme as... Wait, what was that? It was a visual novel called Yume Miru Kusuri, which I read, like, some years ago. And there was one road with a girl like this. She was bullied, like, holy fuck, a lot. And she was also kinda this personality. And it was the best road of the novel, to be honest. Because the rest was like... But yeah. Anyway, I'm afraid that it might spike up. I'm really afraid. I'm not so sure that's what happened. Do I really look that upset to you? Ill will. Even though I couldn't be sure that was the case, I was shaken to my core. It was a feeling of uncertainty, incomparable to anything else. You are not me. You just said, like, you are not me, and I am not you. So it doesn't matter if you are worried or not, I have my rights to be worried about you. Remember that. She tried to encourage me in her own way. I will see you tomorrow, I said in a loud voice as we parted. She couldn't be okay with this. If she was, why was she so desperately looking for it at first? And when I offered to help, she looked as if her savior had appeared before her. There were plenty of arguments I could make, But I didn't. Okay. I don't know if baseball practice is the right way today for the episode. Right after such emotional, you know. Play with Nishizono. But yeah. Okay, where's Kud? Is she in our team already? I kinda want to hit ball to her. Okay, I need to focus. I'm bad today. God damn it! Yeah, I will. Oh my god, yes! Okay. Why there? I don't get it. Why I'm always like pitching the ball like this side? Like what the hell? Come on! I did like a lot of combos lately. What the fuck? You sabotaging me? I know. God damn it. Slaynya! Haha! I did it. Okay, your balls are easy. Give me more of these. Oh, god damn it. Okay. Oh, Kud is there! Kud, take it! I managed to bat the slime. Slime, yeah. Okay, I'm getting better. Woo! Nice, okay. I want Kud to take the ball. I'll take. Oh! Man, I want to see how Kud catch it. The fuck? What the hell was that change up? That was a new move, I think. What the hell? No, I don't kill me. That's the last one! Hell yeah! Oh well. But still, I managed to hit the raging meow ball. We are getting pretty good. Yes, let's continue practice. I'm going to continue like every single baseball practice. We have to win the match. I have no idea like with who and stuff, but yeah, it's apparently going to happen. Okay.
Batting to shibi renshu start.
Let's go. Nice. Aww. It was very light. Don't get angry.
That's
one. Well, that was bad from me. Okay, never mind. Nice. Woo! Let's do it. Ah. I really love these baseball mini games. Did you like them when you played this game? What do you think about this mini game baseball? God damn it. Did you always had Did you also had like problems with ball going to like left side all the time? She certainly did. And I as well. Oh fuck, I was looking at cats. What the fuck do you mean? Oh, I managed to get a... Nice. Okay, I will go with the high ball now. Like that. Oh, okay, that was bad. No, I don't. It's totally random. I have no idea. Oh no, no! What the fuck was that? She... That was a, like a new power? Purve. So she became shaman. And she infused the ball with the cat's souls. Yeah. No need to seek my approval with those glittering guys every time. Rin has learned Purve. Wait, okay. That Purve sounds like pretty OP. Nice. Why I cannot hit the one that goes like this direction? Oh wow, that was fast. Slime, hot damn it. Also, it's one of the rare practices that I didn't get hit. So that's good. Nice one. After the day practice, we went to in search of the future Kud had mentioned before. Furniture Kud had mentioned before. Alright, let's get going then. Whoa! What's with this huge key? She was holding a key that was roughly 50 centimeters in length. What the fuck? No kidding, but what kind of key is that? How the fuck is that possible? It's like a Minotaur will come out if you use it. No. I answered crossing my arms. That we really need in Theseus. What we really need is Theseus. Yeah. So what should we entrust this role to? Who should we entrust this role to? I think we all know who's Theseus gonna be. In our mission to get furniture out. Do you know? And who do you think should be? Let me know in the comment. And I will see the next one. So that was an amazing episode. Thank you, and I will see you in the next one. So for now, Pocket Watch is going out.